Students, in this session, I'm going to discuss tricks to solve thermochemistry problems easily. This is one of the most important concepts from thermochemistry. Problems are very, very important. In this video, I'm going to discuss enthalpy of formation, enthalpy of combustion, because before solving the problems, you should have a complete idea of formation and combustion. Then only you can solve these questions easily. After that, I am going to discuss if in the question only about formation data is given, how to solve those kind of questions. And in the question, if they give only combustion data, how to solve those kind of questions. Some questions, what they do is they give the mixed data. This is most important case, where generally students feel difficult. Here, in this kind of questions, they give both formation and combustion. Then how to solve these kind of questions easily, I'm going to cover in this video. So watch up to the end of this video. Definitely you are going to get very good knowledge as well as tricks to solve this concept easily. Let's start this video. Enthalpy of formation. What is this enthalpy of formation? It is the enthalpy change during the formation of one mole of a compound from its constituent elements. We call it as enthalpy of formation. What is enthalpy of combustion? It is the enthalpy change during the combustion of one mole of a substance. We call it as enthalpy of combustion. This we generally do in the presence of excess amount of oxygen. Let us see the definitions. It is enthalpy change during the formation of what, students? One mole of compound from its constituent elements which are in their standard states. Clear? And here, it is energy change when one mole of a compound is combusted in excess of air. That is called enthalpy of combustion. Here I used standard states, and standard enthalpy of formation for these compounds is assumed as zero. Which one for standard states? What are these standard states? Standard states is nothing but the presence of element in their purest form in the nature. We call it as standard states. For example, carbon present as a graphite. This is the most standard state when compared to diamond. Because carbon in the graphite state is thermodynamically more stable than the diamond. That is the reason only graphite is considered as a standard state to the carbon. I am going to give you few lists. See here, this is most important. This is very, very important. Note this list and keep with you while solving this thermochemistry problems. It will help you. Carbon exists as in graphite state, and oxygen present in as O2 in the gaseous state in nature. You have to take only this form as a standard state, not O3 as a standard state for oxygen. Hydrogen present as H2 in gaseous state. Chlorine present as Cl2 in gaseous state. Fluorine present as F2 in gaseous state. Nitrogen present as N2 in gaseous state. Bromine present as a liquid in gaseous state. Bromine present as Br2 in liquid state. Iodine present as I2 in solid state. Like this, this data is very, very important. And coming to this, how to write the standard enthalpy of formation. First, what is the standard enthalpy of formation? What is the difference between enthalpy of formation and standard? Means, whenever the reaction is taking place at standard conditions like 1 bar pressure and 1 molar concentration and temperature usually like 25 degrees Celsius, we call it as standard enthalpy of formation. In the same way, standard enthalpy of combustion also, even at the same conditions, we call it as standard enthalpy of combustion. Let us see this, how we represent this enthalpy of formation is delta. Because change in enthalpy we are going to find, because we cannot find the absolute enthalpy, delta F of H. What it means? We can write in this way also, delta HF. This is the representation of enthalpy of formation. For standard enthalpy of formation, just to put not here, then which stands for standard enthalpy of formation. In the same way, enthalpy of combustion is delta CH, or delta HC. How to write standard enthalpy of combustion is just put not here. This is the representation of enthalpy of formation and enthalpy of combustion. Here I am going to discuss the most important point. See here students, if you want to do the formation of 1 mole of ammonia, write this 1 mole of ammonia in the product side. Clear? Suppose you want to prepare gaseous ammonia. What are the reactants? What are the elements which is having nitrogen and hydrogen? What you have to do is write nitrogen N here and hydrogen H here. Clear? But nitrogen exists as in which form I told you in the nature? You have to take that only. Nitrogen as N2 in gaseous state. And hydrogen is present as H2 in gaseous state. You have to take that only. Clear? Now, next important trick while writing this reaction is, we want to do the formation of ammonia only 1 mole. So here the coefficient is only 1 mole. According to this, you have to balance the reactants. Got the clarity? Nitrogen, only 1 nitrogen, but here is 2 is there. So take half, because how many nitrogens N2 means 2. 2 nitrogens, if you take half, gets cancelled, then only 1 nitrogen will be left. And in the same way, H2, how many are there? 3 here. Here, 2 hydrogens only there. So, take 3/2. Means, 2 hydrogens and you are taking 3/2 gets cancelled. What will be left? 3 means, which means 3/2 H2 means 3 hydrogens. This is the exact equation. Enthalpy of formation reaction of ammonia. This kind of reaction writing is most important in thermochemistry chapter. See here. If you want to do the formation of 1 mole of CO2, how to write this reaction? CO2 gas, if you want to prepare, means elements carbon and oxygen. After that, what are the standard states? Carbon graphite is the standard state. Oxygen O2 in gaseous state is the standard state. This is 1 mole. So carbon is 1 mole and oxygen, how many are there? 2 is there. So O2. That's it. This is the standard equation. Learn this. Take different examples and learn writing of formation reactions. Let us see the combustion. For example, you want to do the combustion of H2. Then take what you are going to do the combustion product side. This reaction takes place in excess of oxygen. So write O2. And in the product side, write H2O. I am taking as liquid. Why? Because at room temperature, H2O exists as a liquid only. That is the reason I am taking H2O liquid. And H2, standard state is gaseous state. And O2, standard state also gaseous state. Now, this is only for 1 mole. Because we want to combust only 1 mole of a compound. Now, with respect to this, balance the remaining. Got the clarity, students? What is the trick? Here, with respect to product. Here, with respect to reactant, you have to balance the reaction. Next, how many oxygens are there? Only 1. Here, 2. So, take half O2. This is the standard equation. Now, I am going to discuss the most important trick. See this. Delta H is equal to product enthalpy minus reactant enthalpy. This is in terms of formation. Very, very important. And delta H is equal to reactant enthalpy minus product enthalpy. This is for combustion. While solving numericals, you have to keep this in mind and you have to solve. Suppose, see this reaction. A is converting into B. X moles of A converts into Y moles of B. What is the stoichiometric coefficient here? X. What is the stoichiometric coefficient is Y. Now, how to write the reaction for this? Delta H is equal to enthalpy of product. How many moles? Y moles of B. So, I'll write delta HB minus X moles of delta HA. Clear, students? For standard conditions, H0. Here also H0. This is for formation. Delta F of H. Now delta C of H combustion. How to write products? Reactants minus product. X moles of enthalpy of. This is for formation, right? So write F here. Combustion C of H A0 minus Y moles of delta combustion H B0. Y reactants minus products. This is important. this is while doing theory questions, you have to write all this. But while doing the numericals, directly take product minus reactant for formation and reactant minus products for combustion and do the numericals. Now I am going to discuss the most important numericals. Let us see one of the JE question. The question is, what is the correct expression for the formation of standard enthalpy of formation of HBr? See students, HBr formation we want. So write it in product side. HBr in which state we want? We want in gaseous state. Take it in gaseous state. What are the elements which is having? Hydrogen. And what is the other element which is having? Bromine. Clear. And in nature how it exists? H2, and it exists as Br2. This is in gaseous state. This will be in liquid state. Most important. I gave you the data already. And you have to balance the reaction. Always you have to consider for 1 mole of formation. And if you take 2 mole, that is not standard enthalpy of formation. Only for 1 mole. Then how many hydrogens we want? Only 1. So take it as half. And only 1 Br, so take it as half. That's it. You solve this JE equation very easily. What is the correct option for this? This is the correct option. If you mark this, both look same. But here bromine is in liquid state. Here it is in gaseous state. If you mark this, this is the wrong. Clear? See this question students, C2H2 gas means this reacts with H2 and we are getting C2H6. You are going to calculate delta H to this reaction. Enthalpy of formation of this is given as X1 and enthalpy of formation of C2H6 is given as X2. What you have to do is first write the reaction. Which reaction? This reaction, C2H2. Plus 2H2 gives rise to C2H6. What I taught you, if it is enthalpy of formation, you have to write the formula as delta H is equal to enthalpy of products minus enthalpy of reactants. Short way is, product is how much? Enthalpy of product is X2 minus reactants is these two. Means, suppose if you consider this, how much is given? X1 plus 2 into enthalpy of hydrogen. But here enthalpy of hydrogen is not, I am not writing in expression form because it is waste of your time in objective examination. If you want to do for theory exams, then go through the formula which I gave here. Understand, in this formula you write. So 2 into H2, and H2 hydrogen is not given in question. What you have to do is, hydrogen present in their standard states, then it is assumed as 0. What is the formula students then? X2 minus X1. Here I didn't take the values, just I am taking as X2 and X1 to make you clear of this concept. In next video, I will take the best examples and I will do the problems. Coming to the next one. To the same reaction, you have to find delta H, but enthalpy of combustion is asking. Then what is the formula? Enthalpy of combustion, you have to do reactants minus products is a formula. This is important. What is enthalpy of reactants? C2H2 is given as how much? X1 plus 2 into hydrogen is considered as X2. So 2 into X2, this is reactants minus products. What is the enthalpy of combustion of C2H6? C2H6 is given as X3. So this is the formula. What is the formula? X1 plus 2 into X2 minus X3 is your formula. See this question. Same question, but the data is different. In this question, enthalpy of combustion of this is given as C2H2 is given as X1. And enthalpy of combustion of C2H6, H2 is given as X1 and C2H6 is given as X3. And enthalpy of formation of H2O is given. What you have to do? Enthalpy of formation of H2O is given. So write the expression. Every data you can write as an expression. Directly also you can substitute. But here, in order to make you clear, I am writing in the form of expression. Enthalpy of combustion of C2H2. What it means? C2H2 plus O2 gives rise to CO2 plus H2O. Because we do combustion in the presence of oxygen. Then for 1 mole we do this. So 1 mole of this means balance with respect to C2H2, how many carbons? 2 carbons. How many hydrogens? 2 hydrogens balanced. How many oxygens? 2 2s are 4 and 1 5. So 5 by 2. This is a balanced equation. Name this expression as, suppose B. Consider this as A reaction. We want to find delta H of combustion to this reaction. So I'm considering it as a B. And what is the combustion value given for this? As X1. This is given in the question as X1. Next one, enthalpy of combustion of C2H6. Write this. C2H6 plus O2 gives rise to CO2 plus H2O. Students, to make you clear, I'm balancing. But in short, without balancing this and all, you can do directly. How many carbons? 2 carbons. And how many hydrogens? 6. So 3. And 2s are 4, 7, 7 by 2. This is the equation. Name it as C. During this, enthalpy of combustion considered as X3. This is easy. Directly you can substitute. Why I am discussing? Because of this, enthalpy of formation is given. 2 in terms of combustion, 1 in terms of formation. How to do is, write the formation. H2 plus half O2 gives rise to H2O. Now this is in gaseous. Write its expression given in liquid state. Here, observe here, enthalpy of formation of H2O is nothing but enthalpy of combustion of H2. That's it. Both are same. Then, in this question, you can directly substitute the value of X2. Now, write down delta H is equal to, we want C2H2 in reactant side. So, here in expression B, it is there in reactant side 1 mole. Here also 1 mole. So, take it as B into 1. Plus, here H2, so how many are there? 2 hydrogens is there in reactant side. Here only 1 hydrogen. So, take this expression 2 times. 2 into X2. B is how much? Students, X1. So, X1 plus 2 into X2. Here, C2H6 is given in reactant side, product side. Here it is in reactant side, C2H6. So, take it as minus of X3. That's it. What is the answer? X1 plus 2 into X2 minus X3 is your answer. Now this question I am taking from NCRT. See, this is looking too long question, but use this trick what I discussed and solve this question. Next video I am going to do some more important numericals in an easy way. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. I thought to do this video in short, but I discussed many points, so it became a little long. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching.